Hello and welcome to Tesca Technologies Private Limited. My name is Shivam Vijay. Today in this video, I am going to giving a demo on switching mode power supply trainer or the SMPS trainer. The SMPS is a basic power supply in which the power from any AC or DC source is converted using a control rectifier and the controlling bridge within high frequency switching devices like semiconductor devices. So semiconductor devices produces a high frequency chopping circuit by which the DC is rectified and the DC supply is provided to any of the DC circuits. So by training on this SMPS trainer board, the students and any of the learner can easily get the working of the complete SMPS, how the SMPS works with the all characteristics of different blocks are also explained in this video, so that one can easily understand the SMPS working in an easy way. So while working with this kit and while performing the experiment, you can also completely understand all parts of the SMPS, and then we will also see some practicals working for this, how the SMPS works and how the supply is provided to the DC circuits. Also we will see the load characteristics on the SMPS as well. We will also incorporate the regulation test, in which nowadays SMPS are working with very high range of supply, input supply to providing from AC source, so that we will use an variac for this, so that we can provide supply from a very big range and we can get the output and the working of the SMPS according to the input supply as well. So now we are going to move to the complete circuit description of the trainer kit, and then we will follow the practical as per the user manual, and we will see how the SMPS works and try to explain the complete concept of the SMPS working as well. So this is the complete board of Zetum SMPS trainer, in which there are different blocks. This is the line and neutral terminal at which we can check the line and neutral power supply, which is input from the input socket. Input socket is on the upper right back side. You can connect the input cable for power cord for providing the input supply to the complete trainer board. Then this is the complete circuit presented over here on the complete glass epoxy PCB, in which this is the input supply line and neutral 230 volt directly passing through the line filter. So any ripples and harmonics content from the complete supply is firstly passed and filtered. Then this is directly provided to the diode bridge, the bridge of four diodes, which will convert the complete sine wave to the full wave rectifier, so that this is the rectifier and the output is directly rectified in the some amount of DC, so that this DC is as a volt, this behave as a voltage doubler circuit, so that our power supply, which is about 230 volt, will be get in about the 320 volt DC. We can check this on the terminal T1 and T2 as well. Then the complete supply is directly passing through the SMPS controller, in which the PWM control pulses control the switching of the MOSFET here. The MOSFET is the main semiconductor switching device. It is work on a high frequency switching, so that it can be easily converted to the DC power supply. Moving on to the next circuit. So this is the SMPS controller, in which we are using AC3842. This is a IC that will be convert and sense the current value. According output will be phased and provided to the gate circuit of the MOSFET for switching, and input supply is provided here as well. So basically complete controlling of SMPS based on different parts, in which this is the input rectifier first, then we have an inverter chopper, then the output transformer and input rectifier and filter, also the chopper control feedback as well also provided for this. In this AC half wave and full wave rectified signal, if the SMPS has an AC input, its first job is to convert the input to the DC. This is called rectification. The rectification circuit can be configured as a voltage doubler by addition of a switch operated either the manually or automatically. This is a feature of larger supplies to permit operation from normally 120 volt or 240 volt supplies. So this supply is passed through the complete voltage doubler or diode bridge rectifier, so that supplied will be converted directly in the DC supply. Then we have the inverter stage. In the inverter stage, DC, whether the directly from the input from the rectifier stage, as we provide input from the rectifier stage, or the AC by running it through a power oscillator whose output transformer is very small with a few windings at a frequency of 10 or hundreds of the kilohertz. The frequency is usually chosen to be above the 20 kilohertz for the complete SMPS working to make it inaudible for humans. The output voltage is optically coupled to the input, thus very tightly controlled. The optical isolator is also provided here. The optical isolator providing a very non-contact and non-current flowing device, so that the other circuit can directly couple through the ground, but there will be no any current flown through the optical isolator, so that it will require to control and to provide safety for the SMPS circuit as well. Then we have voltage converter. For that we have provided here the voltage converter, different types of voltage converter IC like 78 series, 79 series, similarly LM series, both all the different type of series are also provided for converting the voltage from different values, from fixed value of DC. Then the power factor is also controlled through the power factor correction circuit. And then we have a load bank over here to provide load for the output voltage generated. So these are the two resistance bank here, the 470 ohm resistance with the 5 watt power capacity are internally connected. So we can use them as per the circuit, and then we see how the resistive load behave according to the voltage applied on it. The basic block diagram or working of SMPS is also described in the user manual, so that the mains input is directly provided to the input rectifier and filter if we are using SMPS for converting AC to DC, and then this will be directly provided to the inverter circuit. And if the SMPS is working with the only DC supply input, so this will be directly provided at this section. Inverter, or we can say chopper, is a high frequency chopping device, so that the input power supply is chopped in the very high frequency, or we can use or the buck boost or boost transformer for DC chopping as well. Then these are the output transformer, also known as buck boost and boost transformer, buck transformer. Both transformer are also can be used as desired value and desired specification. Then this is the input rectifier and filter, so that output rectifier and filter is provided here. Output from the buck boost transformer is directly fed to the input rectifier and filter, so in there as there is any ripples and any harmonic contents or the frequency and converted values, properly DC will be filtered through this complete rectifier section and we get the DC output. Also there is a chopper control feedback system also allowed to controlling the appropriate power factor and to get the proper DC output according to the SMPS value. These are the some basic examples of rectification process, in which when the sine wave is directly fed to the diode rectifier, the diode is in the half wave rectifier, this waveform will be generated and this is further filtered through the output transformer, chopped through the inverter, then will be provided to the output transformer, step up or step down as per the value, and then rectified and filtered according to the output ratings of the SMPS. Similar wave actions will be also happen when we provide the full wave rectifier. This is the full wave rectifier waveform of the AC input. This is the half wave waveform of the AC input. Both are the complete setup so that we can provide the DC from this level. Now moving on for the first experiment, which is the study of rectifier and filter section. In this we will see the rectification and filtered output on the multimeter. For this complete theoretical knowledge is also given in the user manual. We will follow the complete procedure for doing the connections and to checking up the complete value of rectified DC. In this complete procedure is also given in the user manual. We need equipment, the trainer board, SMPS trainer board, oscilloscope with attenuator probe. Then we require a digital multimeter to check the multimeter voltage or check the AC voltage. then we will follow the procedure as described in the user manual and we will understand the rectifier and filter section of this trainer. Now for the practical connections, we just need to turn on the power supply of the trainer board as explained in the user manual. So as I power on the complete trainer board power supply, the power LED starts glowing, you can see. So this is the indication for power on. Now we will measure the input supply at L and N terminal, line and neutral terminal, using digital multimeter in AC mode. So you can see my digital multimeter is in right now in AC mode. So we'll connect the patch cords on the line and neutral terminal carefully and we will observe the voltage is 226, which is the AC power supply for the complete source that we are measuring here. Now we can measure the pulsating rectified DC voltage using multimeter by connecting it to positive of the multimeter at T1, the T1 terminal, and add to the T2 terminal. The pulsating voltage for this, we will first remove the multimeter probes from here and turn this to the DC measurement and connect this to T1 and T2. This will give us the 300 volt DC, approximately 320 volt DC, which is our pulsating voltage for this. So you can see our input voltage, which is 230 volt, which is directly rectified in the DC voltage, which is 320 volt, as an voltage doubler circuit is used for this component, this working. Now in the next experiment, this is a basic theoretical based experiment in which you can study the complete detailed instruction and theory about the optocoupler or opto isolator internal circuit. So in electronics, an opto isolator, opto coupler, opto photocoupler is a device that uses a short optical transmission path to transfer a signal between elements of the circuit, typically a transmitter and a receiver, while keeping them electrically isolated. Since the signal goes from one electrical signal to an optical signal back to an electrical signal, electrical contact along the path is broken. So this is the complete theory. You can study about this. Application of optocoupler are also given in this user manual right now. Several types of optocouplers, the top left and far right, detect the presence of an objective in the between of them. And the working diagram or working circuit is also given in the user manual to explaining the optocoupler power supply, in which this is the LED type of the LED. You basically a LED light emitting diode is used, and this is the photo transistor Q1, so that whenever the switch S1 is closed, the voltage through the LED is going pass on and LED light starts glowing, and this will emit some radiation or some lights that will absorbed by the photo transistor over here and starts conducting through the ground. So that's how opto isolator converts the value, and without making any electrical current passing through with this path, this is a just optical path over here by which we can control the other line or other voltage line supply for the safety purpose as well as for providing the current to turn on and turn off the circuit in the complete section. So this is the complete study of the opto isolator. You can study it in the user manual. Now we move on to our next experiment. Now in the next experiment, we will study the SMPS controller and switching of the trainer. In this, we are using the switching transformer for this purpose, and unlikely this is designed not just to transfer energy but also to store it for a significant friction of the switching period. This is achieved by winding of the coils on a ferrite core with an air gap. The air gap increases the reluctance of the magnetic circuit and therefore its capacity to store the energy. So that's how the switching transformer works. Complete explanation of working of the switching transformer at different frequency and different values or different types of transformer or for switching purpose are also given in this complete study and in complete theory section. details about the construction of this type of transformer and the failure issues of this type of transformer are also given in this user manual. All the theories are given. Now we move on to the seeing the how the controller of the PWM signals are working with the controlling IC which are using for this UC3842, and we will observe the exact output similarly described in the user manual, as same waveform will be also observed on the DSO. For this purpose we will use this, and also measure the different switching voltages at different points, and we will see the frequency of this output of the PWM wave at the point T6 in this complete experiment as well. For this we will require the trainer board and oscilloscope with a tonometer probe of 1:10 and digital multimeter for checking the voltage at different values. Now we will follow the procedure for doing this experiment. For ground, we can use this ground port over here given on the trainer board, and we will connect the AC supply which is already connected. Then we switch on the trainer. Trainer is in on condition right now. Now we will connect with the oscilloscope with 1:10 attenuator probe with 10x position, and at T6 we will observe the waveform with respect to ground. For this we will connect the oscilloscope probe ground terminal, and the other terminal will be connected to T6. This is the test point T6 over here, and we will auto tune the CRO and we will get our PWM waveform. Just need to adjust the CRO level. There, the waveform is the same as given in the user manual. This is the PWM waveform output. You can also measure the frequency at the DSO. The frequency is about 63.49 kilohertz, which is a very high frequency and which is very appropriate for the switching purpose, and this frequency can be higher, but in the general case we will consider the frequency should be more than 20 kilohertz for any of the switching device for switch mode power supply. Now we will also check the voltage at point T3, T4, T5. For this we will connect the negative point of the multimeter DMM to the ground, and we will check the voltage at T3. At T3 we are getting 146, which is our input voltage DC. At T4 we are getting 148, same voltage on the DC as well. Now at T5 this is the gate current voltage, which is 150 volt DC in the negative as well. So these are the all waveforms and complete voltages. You can mention all the voltages for the conclusion in the user manual. All the tables are given so that all the voltages and frequency at 0.6 is mentioned. Hence we have studied the SMPS controller and switching section of the trainer. Now we move on to the next experiment. Now in the next experiment we will study the voltage regulation according to the requirement. In this generally in the SMPS the positive regulator with LM78 series generally used, in which we can convert the voltages accordingly. And this is a 3-terminal regulator available with the several fixed output voltages and making them useful in a wide range of applications. One of these is a local on card regulation, eliminating the distribution problem associated with the single point regulation, and the voltage available allow these regulators to be used in a logic system as well. Instrumentation, hi-fi and other solid state electronic device, this will give the very efficient output for the complete setup. So this is the features of the complete 7-8 series positive regulator in which it can take up to 1 ampere current if the proper heat sink is provided. Internal thermal overload protection is also provided in these types of regulators. No external components required for this. They are 3 terminal device. Just provide to input for input section and take the output with the common and output terminal. Then output transistor, safe area also protection provided. Internal short circuit current limiting is also provided. Available in the aluminium TO3 package. This will be very light in weight and can be easily to use. The voltage range consists of LM7805 for 5 volts output, then LM7812C for 12 volts output, then LM7815C for 15 volt output. So this is about the theoretical description, and this is the picturization and construction design given in the user manual, so that theoretical value and theoretical understanding can be done by studying this. Also, similar negative regulators are also in the market and generally used for the regulation purpose. Similar values and similar capacities and similar functions are also provided just in the negative cycle. The pin number 1 is of the ground, pin number 2 is for the input, and pin number 3 is for the output. You have to provide the input on ground and pin number 2 and take the input from ground and pin number 3. So these are complete details. T suffix plastic package case 221A is also provided. Heat sink surface need to be provided. Proper heat sink can be stable for the value for up taking up to the 1 ampere load. This is the 79 series, which comes in complete negative voltage regulation. The LM series fixed output negative voltage regulation are intended as complement to the popular MC78 series devices. These negative regulators available in the same 7 voltage options as the MC78 devices. All the voltage range given in the 78 series, the positive regulator, all voltages for negative regulators are also provided. Now we will see the output of different values in which we are using the different regulators, and we will use a digital multimeter to take the output for voltage regulation section. All the regulators are internally connected circuits of the regulator. How the regulator is directly coupling with the SMPS is also drawn and printed on the main screen. You can study the circuit diagram as well. Then we will check the voltage at different values. For T7, as here we are using 7812, this is the positive regulator for 12 volt supply, so we are getting 12 volt DC supply on the digital multimeter as well. Now we will check the voltage at 7912, this is the negative voltage regulator, so we are getting the negative same 12 volts but in the negative volt value. So 79 series is for negative regulation. Then we have 7905, so this will give us the negative 5 volt DC supply, and we have LM317 for 3.3 volt power supply. So this is positive value, LM3.928 supply. Almost 3.3 DC volts we are getting for this digital multimeter. So this is the all values. Also, we are using here the positive supply using the complete diode regulation. So this is positive 5 volt supply with the diode regulation voltage. So these two types of the regulation, these are the fixed 3 terminal regulation. This is also a 3 terminal regulation using LM317 regulator, and this is complete circuit based regulation for step down the voltage from 103 volts to diode using 5 volts in the positive output. So this is how regulation of the regulation of the voltage DC is provided through the SMPS. Now we move on to the next experiment. Now in the next experiment, we will study the SMPS in the load condition. For this, we will require current meter, analog or digital, as per the requirement. Right now we have only digital meter, so we will working with the digital meter as well. Procedure for setting up the complete section is given here, and the load bank, as I explained earlier in the complete video, the load bank is provided. Now we will see output according to the load. For this, the circuit diagram and circuit connections has to be made as per the user manual. Now for the load regulation, we will see, for this we will connect the positive First, we have to turn off the trainer board while working with the load. Just turn off the trainer board for safety purpose of the trainer. Now, we will connect the positive output of 12 volt supply to any of the resistive load here. And to check the current through the resistive load, you can connect the digital multimeter or analog multimeter in series with the 313 terminal. Connect positive point of the analog meter to this point and the other point of the analog meter with the ground supply. So we are directly connecting the positive of the DMM here. Just need to first change this to the milliampere range. And now we will connect positive and ground to the ground terminal of this trainer board. Now as we turn on the circuit, the 12 volt power supply through the ground is provided to the 470 ohm resistance. We will check the current passing through at the digital multimeter. Now as I turn on the circuit, you can see the current is almost 24 milliampere for this. So if we calculate the actual power or the resistance value, so the input power or input voltage is 12, and if we multiply this with the 24 volt, we will get the resistance value, which is approximately 500 for this. Now similarly, we can increase the resistance by connecting both the resistance in the series. For this, we will turn off the trainer board, remove the positive supply of the meter, connect both the resistance in series like this, connecting T13 terminal with the T14 terminal, and at the other one, now both the resistance has been connected in series, so current passing through will be decreased because the resistance is increased. Now again turn the training board and we will get the approximately half current in the last one when we are working with the single resistance of 470 ohm, and in this value now we are connecting two 470 ohm resistance in series, so completely is about 1000 ohm, and we are getting approximately 12 volts in the output, sorry, 12 milliampere in the output. So when we calculate this, we will get accurate resistance value as per the user manual and as per the value. We can also perform the parallel combination for this circuit. For this, we have to connect both the resistance in parallel and we will observe the output on the DMM. Now for making the parallel connection of both the resistance bank, just need to connect patch cords on both the ends of resistance value here. So that's how we have parallelly connected both the resistance. Now we just have to provide the positive supply to any of the resistance short terminal, and other end is behaving like the parallel joint of the resistance bank. Now we'll check the milliampere value. As the resistance in parallel decreased, so our current value is quite increased in the DMM, which is now 46 milliamperes. So this can be measured up to the value according to the output. So that's how we perform the current loading on this. Now we move on to our next experiment. Now moving to our next experiment, we will require to connect a variac for this, as we are going to study the SMPS trainer with variac input or variable AC. In this, we are observing the regulation test of the SMPS so that we can get the appropriate minimum and maximum value of the AC input for this SMPS trainer, and we can observe at which minimum value we will getting the appropriate output at the DC level, and we will provide this. Now for this experiment, we required digital multimeter. You can use 1 meter or 2 meter. Right now for continuous process, I am using 2 digital multimeter for this process. The left one we will use for checking the input voltage power supplied from the variac for this, and for the left one we will observing the output voltage generated by the SMPS. There are 2 methods to conclude this complete experiment. You can use a variac with an AC socket in which you have to connect the supply, AC supply of the SMPS directly through the AC socket using the patch power cord provided with the trainer, or you can connect the variac output as I am not having a socket in this variac, so that I am using direct patch cord to this L and N terminal. While working this, just make sure you remove the complete power connections from the earlier connection that we have done here. The complete trainer board should be free from any of the power source. The power will be only provided from the variac. The line and neutral terminal should also be properly connected, line with the line and neutral with the neutral, so that there will be no any internal damage occurs in the circuit. Now for this, we will first connecting the output of variac. Make sure you properly turn off all the supplies while working with this. So we will connect the output of variac to the trainer board, and then we will observe the line neutral terminal output with the DMM. So I am connecting right now line with the line and neutral terminal with the neutral. Here at starting, the variac is at completely zero position. The zero voltage is output for this. So now I am connecting the DMM1 for setting up and to measuring the AC voltage. Carefully connect. And now we will also connect the digital multimeter 2 for this, to maintaining the output of SMPS. So this is the digital multimeter 2 that has been connected. Now we will turn on both the meters. Here the meter 2 is set for the DC voltage measurement at the DC range, and this is for the AC range. Now we will slightly increase the voltage slowly, and at which value we will see the SMPS output is properly responded. So now I am increasing the voltage slowly with the variac. So I started increasing the voltage. We can observe the voltage AC input supplied on the DMM right now. This is showing 10 volts, 15 volts AC, 20 volt AC, 30 volt AC. This is now 35. Here you can see now the meter 2 is start responding and having some value, because the switching is inside the trainer is starting. And as we reach from 35 to 40 volts approx, there is some fluctuations, so it will trying to start the SMPS output. So till 40 we do not get any output. Now I have increased the voltage 45. If I decrease the voltage, I have seen the responded output on the DMM right now. So at 45 voltage AC, we have respond, the SMPS has been respond and giving the 12 volt output. Now if I decrease the voltage again, we'll see how much decrement is required for SMPS to be not responding. So if I decrease voltage less than 40 volts, here the response is slightly going down, and right now the value is completely zero. So there is some starting voltage required. So we'll consider the 45 volts AC is for the minimum voltage for SMPS to respond. This is almost working at 41.4 or 40 volts for the response to DC voltage. So we can consider 40 volts as a complete output response or the minimum value for this SMPS so that it will start working at 40 volts. But it depends if we provide any maximum load or more load, so we require more voltage. So we'll now continually increase the voltage and see at which value and which is the maximum value till the variac maximum output is provided. So output can be generated on the maximum value as well. So now we will continually increase the voltage and see how voltage respond and the SMPS respond according to the voltage. So I am increasing the voltage from 40, which is our minimum to be considered for this setup, and in continuously increasing the voltage. This is now 100 volts. ₹150, ₹180, ₹200, and this is now almost 220 voltage. So 220 volt supply is already provided here. There is no fluctuation in the response of the output. We are getting proper output at 12 volts. Also, we will observe the different outputs, like minus 12 volt, we are getting minus 5 volts. Yes, we are getting both the volts. So this is the maximum and appropriate range. Now we can increase the range till maximum value of the variac and we see, is there any deflection in the output? 230, 240 volts AC, 250, 260, and this is the maximum 263 voltage. 100% output from the variac has been considered. So we can consider the range is from minus 40 volt AC to 260 volt for the rest safe purpose. So we can consider 260 volt is the maximum working range for this SMPS trainer unit, or we can provide some more range, but the variac has the more efficiency and the complete range of the variac has been provided for this. You can, if you have any variac which have the range up to 300 or more than that value, you can provide the value to the SMPS and observe the output where it will start not responding for this. So this is how we have seen the voltage regulation test on the SMPS trainer, and I hope you will get the proper understanding about complete values on the trainer board. So in the user manual, after taking minimum and maximum value, you can mention them inside this, and that's how your training of SMPS trainer and working of SMPS trainer that we have completed with this video. So this was the complete demonstration on the practical training board of SMPS trainer, in which we have studied the working of SMPS. I have tried to explain the concept of SMPS switching mode power supply, in which we have seen the voltage regulators, in the positive voltage regulators and the negative voltage regulator, both the working of the regulations of testing are also done and carried out in this complete video. Also, we have tested the load characteristics and how the SMPS and output voltage behave on the load with the load being provided on the trainer board. And we have also studied the regulation test by providing a supply with the lower range AC to higher range AC for this SMPS and see how the response is getting for this. And also we have carried out the PWM response by CRO on the waveform. So this is a complete explanation about the SMPS trainer. So I hope you will get the proper understanding with this, and while working with this kit, if you find difficulties, you can contact to Tesca Technologies Private Limited for all types of supports. And order code of this complete setup is 10945. You can use this order code to find out the specification, to find out what you can study with the complete setup of SMPS trainer by visiting our website, which is www.tescaglobal.com. Also, if you like the content of this video and this is very beneficial for you, so you can press the like button, and also you can share the complete video for the needy ones, your colleagues, your friends, your students or your children, to find out and to get the detailed explanation about the SMPS. And there are a lot of many type of videos for clearing the all concepts regarding education purpose, so that you can easily refer the video to them so that they can get the easily explanation, practical explanation as well on the complete trainer board. So you can follow our channel, which is Tesca Tech, which is on the YouTube, and don't forget to press the like button. If we upload next video, you can get the notification for that as well. So till then, thank you for watching this video, and we'll meet in the next video.